Hi guys, and welcome back to Fly Tying with me, Tellis Katsougianos, and this is episode 2 out of 12 that's to come. We did the autumn fly last week, and we're continuing with salmon flies and tube flies. And today we're going to do monkey styles, D-monkey. It's a very, very efficient salmon fly, and it works more or less in every river, in most conditions. You just have different sizes of it, different weights, a little bit slimmer dressing sometimes, or a little bit thicker with more materials. It depends on the condition. But the base pattern itself is a fantastic fly, and it will work in murky, peaty waters. It will work in very clear waters as well. So it's an awesome fly. And just as previous flies that we tied, everything that you need material-wise you will find in my links in the description. You will also find a blog post talking more about my how I got into finding that fly, or how I got introduced to it, and the journeys or it has taken me on. My first ever Springer caught in River Dee, for example, was caught on a yellow Dee monkey. And so, of course, that's a fly that will always be in my fly box. Okay, so the monkey style flies we're going to tie today is a yellow Dee monkey, like this one. And of course, you can do how many variation in colors as you want. It's a very good base pattern that works most places, or more or less every salmon river you can choose. Taking a 10 millimeter US tube, I find that a very good in between size or medium size for most flies. Then take that out on the 1.8 millimeter tube, and then I'm burning a small little edge here in the back to prevent the tube from slipping off. And that sound is me blowing on that one, so it cures or hardens faster. A little drip of Loctite, then just push it all the way to that edge, like so. Then you slide that onto your tube needle, like that. Like the last fly, most of the tying, or all the fly tying, will be in front of the metal. I want this to be clean to make the flies sink faster if needed. The more material I cover here, or the more the metal gets covered, the slower the fly will sink. So just attach it in front there, and I will add just a little bit of dubbing. This kind of long strand dubbing can also be used as flash. If you add more here and brush it out, it will go into the wing. I will just make a little bit like this, and this is how I normally dub. I just put it on and spin it around. This works for any type of flies, woolly buggers, salmon flies. Any synthetic dubbing works perfectly to do this. And if you want to see the technique more, I have a video clip made a few years back where I show different dubbing techniques. So look closer to that one if you want to get this technique going better. For these kind of flies, I prefer to have the first wing a little bit stiffer. That will help keep the shape of the fly even in harder, more fast flowing water or rapid water. So what I'm using here is bucktail. You can of course use polar bear, which will give the fly a nice shimmer, but it's also a material that's a little bit it's hard to know whether you can use it with good conscience or not. So if you're having hesitation about that, use bucktail. It has the same features, but it doesn't have that shimmer. Okay. And I will not tie this forward and then, or reversed and then flip it over, because this is very stiff material. It is easier to just two or three loose wraps, and then you slowly add pressure to it. So making it there. This will of course leave a lot of unwanted materials here in the front. So what I normally do here is I add just a few drops of glue to the thread, like so. Then, because that will sink in a little bit, securing it, and then I will take the razor blade and cut this as close as I can towards the thread there. Like so. Okay, next step. As usual, I like angel hair, and I most of the time am pretty sparse with using it, so I just take one strand here, one lap, and then turn it over. So it's one that I fold, so I have two strands of flash in the wing. For me personally, I think that's enough. Make sure that these are not the same length when you adjust and cut, because those will get stick together in the water. So you can see it's a little bit different length there. All right, now it's time for the hackle. And I'm once again using a rooster saddle for this. And I'm gonna find a good size here. What I want with the fibers, I want them to be about a third of the total wing length. And I will show you that when it's the fly is more done. But if you can imagine when I do this, the total wing length will be about here. So one, two, three. That will create a very good proportion and aesthetic in the fly. For and I think that's mostly for us. But who doesn't want to have pretty flies in their box? Clean away the things that you don't want or are going to use. I'm going to use this feather all the way towards where just before it starts to get that almost marabou fluffy. I don't like that, so I cut that away. I'm slowly just pulling those fibers back and I'm cutting there. This little triangle that I've created here, that's what I'm gonna attach to that hump there that I got from the bucktail. Just a few laps and then secure it just below. That will make it easier to really get that one to stick. Once again, I'm taking the scissor, not the sharp inside that you're cutting with, but the other sharp edge there. Put that towards your hackle and modify or manipulate the fibers by bending them, slowly as pulling upwards. This will make it way easier for me to duplicate the hackle like this. So, first wrap here, finger and thumb, pinch and release the stem, and then take a reversed grip. And I'm making three wraps on that big ugly hump there to cover it, then the rest just below it to cover any signs of the thread. Keep pulling back, release the stem, reverse grip every time. Then I'm putting a few loose wraps with my left hand, then securing it like so. Having a rotating vise is of course simplifies things a lot, but it's not needed. But as you can see, when I'm doing all of these things, it's a little bit easier to work. What you can do here is just brush down the hackle a little bit. But now you can see we have a very nice base to this fly, very nice shape. And the final step here of the actual building of the fly is adding a softer hair material on top, in this case fox hair. And this should be a little bit longer than the first one. And cut. Always look for the natural taper in the wing. Where is it? As you can see, this is pretty straight and boring, but you have a tendency of shorter hair here. So start pulling away a little bit. And you can see that a wing with better taper is starting to show itself. Finger, thumb, and pull that finger backwards, and you can see that you're now manipulating the taper even more. Pinch here, and you can see that we are now creating a very nice drip-shaped soft wing, like so. clean away this by cutting. This one I'm going to tie reversed. So the short hair needs to be pointing up at this point, and the long will be on the underside. Otherwise it will be the opposite when you flip this backwards. So then take this one and fold it over. Doing this leaves a very nice clean space here in the end. As you can see, there's nothing in front that I need to remove. Then I always take the brush to just comb through to see if everything ended up where I wanted it. Sometimes you need to redo this, but this looks like a good shape of fly. So this is enough, of course, but we're gonna add those jungle cock cheeks because the fly looks a little bit prettier. But this is purely cosmetic for the salmon angler. I don't think there's any salmon in the world that cares if you have these on or not. But now you can see that the hackle is about a third of the total wing length. And that includes now when you're putting these cheeks on to create a nice proportion, it should be about a third. If I start adding length to it, or if it's too short, it won't look as good for the human eye. But once again, it's the salmon, so it's the salmon that we want to have a reaction out of. But it is nice to show your friends some nice flies. Cleaning away what I'm not gonna use, putting that aside, pinching with my thumb here. Then sometimes I unwrap a few times and then add them again, like three times, like so. Right, then we're gonna take the other side, and then we are at the finishing stage. Like so, measuring here. Here you will see once again why it's good to have rotation wise. Pull that off. Because now it's easier to see that you're putting it in the same length and angle and everything. One, two, three. Like so. These ones I always fold back, because this will, of course, create a stronger fly, because it's stuck twice or tied in twice. Same with the black hair wing, the fox that I put on. The bucktail, after fishing a lot, there is a risk that that will slip out. Or if you compare to the black wing, because that's stuck, it's tied on twice because we folded it. Same with this jungle cock cheeks here. Cut away those access points there. Now make sure it's secure, like so. Now I'm using glue here. Super glue, fast. I never use any whip finish or anything. Haven't felt the need for it. 4 or 5 wraps while the glue is still wet. I cut that off. Make sure to pinch in that little thread that I was cutting off, the axis there. So what you can do now is either put a lot of coats with varnish and glue to make that head shiny. You can also put UV glue that will create a very nice shiny head, as you can see here. I will do so to show you. First, taking this off, it makes it easier to create. So I'll take this off, cut or use the razor blade as close as I can. Take the lighter, just a little dab here, like so. Sometimes you can put it back on the needle when you're burning, like this. But if you're a little bit cautious, that you don't have to worry too much about melting the eye or the hole, as long as you're not rushing it. Then I'm putting the glue on here. There's a little bit of stuff in the way here. Once again, the rotating vise is a little bit beneficial here, of course. Something like that. And while this is still liquid, I shape the head with a needle.
moving around, making sure it's nice and even. Like so, and then I'll take the pen. Let's see. Here we go. And just start curing that with this UV light. Make sure to be a little bit careful by touching the head too soon. Sometimes the UV glue needs a little bit more curing time before it's really, really hard and solid. But it's tack-free now already, so. But avoid taking your fingers to that right now. Same with glue or varnish. All right, the Yellow D Monkey. Fly that works in more or less every Atlantic salmon river in the world. And you can just variate a little bit size and color in the hackle and underwing.